Good morning, students. Today we are discussing current electricity PU board important questions. The weightage of this current electricity lesson is 14 marks. According to new model papers, from this lesson they are asking one numerical and 3 mark questions and 2 and 1 mark questions. Okay. Here previous it is one important 5 mark question is there, but according to new model papers only 3 marks, 2 marks, 1 mark and numericals. Okay, according to that, first question we want to be learned for 1 mark questions. That are in the first question only, I gave so many here. See that first question is define electric current, that is 1 mark question. After that, define SI unit of electric current. Define SI unit of electric current. I am not asking write the SI unit of electric current. Okay. Next one is dimensional formula for it. In that first definition is electric current. Can you define electric current? Very simple. What it is? Rate of law of charges. Rate of, that means by D. So I equal to what you can write? Q by D. Very simple formula. I equal to Q by T or I equal to dQ by dt. Are you understand? Very simple definition. What it is? Rate of flow of charges. It is known as a strength of electric current or simply electric current. What is its SI unit? What is the SI unit of electric current? It is ampere. It is ampere. Because of ampere, the scientist will found it. So, his name only put it as a units, SI units for it. So what are the SI units? It is an ampere. Can you define SI unit of electric current? What I am asking the question, are you understand? Define SI unit of electric current. So many people they wrote only simply ampere, but here we want to be define 1 ampere. Are you understand? So define means we need to be explain. So 1 ampere, how to define that? 1 coulomb of charge flows in a unit time or in 1 second. 1 coulomb of charge flows in a unit time or 1 second in a conductor. Then the electric current is said to be 1 ampere. Then electric current is said to be 1 ampere. Clear na? Very very simple. How to write the dimensional formula for that? It is IRA. Dimensional formula is textbooks they are preferring I, capital I, or some textbooks they wrote A. The dimensional formula for electric current, it is IRA. Clear? Next one is electric current scalar quantity or vector quantity? Can you explain? Is it electric current scalar or vector? Electric current means both it have, that means direction and magnitude. So is it vector or scalar? Even though it is a scalar only. Why? Because here only I gave the reason. What it is? Current have both magnitude and direction, even though it cannot obey, could not obey laws of vector addition. It could not obey laws of vector addition. So that electric current is not a vector quantity, only scalar quantity. What it is? Only scalar quantity. Here next question is define trip velocity and mobility of free electrons. This is a 2 marks important question. In that first definition is define trip velocity. Very simple. The average velocity with which free electrons in a conductor drifted in the direction opposite to the applied electric field. The direction opposite to the applied electric field. It is called drift velocity. See here upon the board, the drift velocity, the average velocity with which free electrons in a conductor are drifted in a direction opposite to the direction of, opposite to the direction of applied electric field or simply electric field. It is known as drift velocity. It represents with Vd. Okay. Next one is a mobility of free electron. What is the mobility of free electron? Mobility of free electron is defined as drift, magnitude of drift velocity per unit electric field strength, or simply unit electric field. Clear na? Magnitude of drift velocity per unit electric field. That means mu equal to mobility of free electrons represented with mu. So mu equals to modulus of Vd by E, or simply Vd by E. How you write? Both are same. Okay, R mu equal to what you can write Vd by E. Clear na? This is a mobility of free electron. Next, what can you define? Current density. Can you define current density? Very simple. Current per unit area of cross sectional. It is known as a current density. Current per unit area of cross sectional. Clear na? That is called current density. Most important. Is it vector or scalar? Vector quantity. What is the formula for that? J equal to I by A. J equal to I by A. Next one is, there is a relation between electric current I and drift velocity Vd. We want to derive this one. I NAE Vd. Drift velocity means Vd, current means I. To derive this relation, we will consider one conductor. This conductor have uniform area of cross section. Uniform area of cross section. Now, the ends of the conductor is connected to a potential difference V. Clear? The potential difference V. Then, what happens? Inside the conductor, the electric field will produce. So, positive ions are moved from higher potential point to lower potential point. Respect to that, electrons are moved from lower potential to higher potential. In between, collisions will occur. Due to these collisions, the velocity can reduce. That average, that reduced velocity we will call as a drifted. Okay? That average drifted electrons velocity, that is called simply drift velocity, we are measuring here. Clear what I am telling? I want to be considered uniform area of cross sectional conductor with length L and ends of the conductor I applied a potential difference, then inside the conductor electric field will produced. Here only that matter. Clear? Considered a conductor of length L and area of cross sectional A when a potential difference V is applied across the conductor and electric field E is produced inside the conductor. Then electrons are drifted with velocity Vd. Then electrons are drifted with velocity Vd. Okay. Let the volume of the conductor, because of area of cross section it is A and length it have L, so volume of the conductor I want to be measured. So V equal to what can I write? Area into length, so AL. Okay, in that volume, in this volume of conductor, how many free electrons to measure that? Here only that I wrote. The number of free electrons present in that volume of conductor, that is capital N. Capital N equal to NaL. Capital N equal to NaL. Here small n is nothing but electron density. That you can write as small n equal to number of electrons per volume. Clear? Volume is nothing but AL. Clear? That is electron density. Clear na? Now, if number of electrons are flow from lower potential to higher potential, or positive ions will move from higher potential to lower potential, then inside the charge can flow. Say yes or no. So that total charge in that conductor is what you can write? Q equal to Ne. What you can write? Q equals to Ne, where E is charge of electron. Where E is a charge of electron. Then the charge flows through a conductor in a time that is called electric current. Strength of electric current. Previous already we learned this definition. Strength of electric current or strength of steady current. I equal to Q by D. So here I equal to, instead of this Q, what we will write? Ne by T. What we will write? Ne by T. Then I equal to, instead of capital N, already we have here NaL. So that I will substitute that NaL small NaL into E by T. Clear na? Why? Because capital N equal to NaL. Already here we defined that. Then after I equal to, for our convenience only, NaE I wrote first. Then after L by T it is distance by time. Basic formula is nothing but velocity. Distance by time, it is nothing but velocity. Say yes or no. So that, what can I write here? I equal to NAE into VD. Because of drift velocity, VD equal to distance or displacement by time. Velocity basic definition it is. So yes or no. So from that, what we learned? I equal to NAE VD. This is the important relation between electric current and drift velocity. It is for 3 more question. Next one is, Write an expression for drift velocity. Here we want to be learned one more question. In the same question we will ask one more type, that is derive an expression for drift velocity of free electrons in a conductor. Free electrons in a conductor. How you can tell? Same model. We will consider one uniform area of cross sectional of conductor and it have length L, and if you applied a potential difference across the ends of the conductor, then electric field will generate, that will be positive potential to negative potential, it will be flows. Okay, electric field is applied like this, then electrons will move opposite for that. Clear? Opposite for that. See here. So that after applied the potential difference between two ends of the conductor, then electrons are drifted. Okay. So electric field, what the produced electric field inside the conductor is. How you write? E equal to V by L. It is the equation number 1. I understand this point. Very simple. What it is? If you be apply a potential difference between the two ends of the conductor here, then electric field is produced inside. So electric field E equal to, what you can write? V by L. It is the equation number 1. Then after, here, after application of electric field, electrons are move from opposite to the applied electric field, that means it acts with some force. Say yes or no. That force will be, the electric field acts some force upon electrons. Upon electrons. So that the force is, how you write? F equal to ma. From that acceleration of the electron, what you can write? That is A equal to F by M. Here A is nothing but, instead of that F, what you can write? One more formula, it is EQ, basic formula. So from that E into Q means here electron, charge is nothing but here electron. So electrons are moving inside the conductor. So what you can write? That is E into E. So A equal to, final equation, what you can write? A equal to capital E, small e by M. Here negative sign will represent opposite direction to the applied electric field. So the magnitude of drift velocity we want to be measured. Magnitude of drift velocity in a conductor. So how you tell? Electrons are move here. First starting it is at rest. Why? Because here no potential difference. Then after applied the potential difference, then only electrons are move from rest to and reach the other end of the conductor. So final velocity, what you can write according to kinematics equations, what you can write? V equal to u plus at. So from that, what you can write? Drift velocity Vd equal to u plus at. Starting from rest, so u equal to 0. Then what you can write? Vd equal to 0 plus minus magnitude of or modulus of minus ee by m into d. Here t is nothing but tau. Why? Because the electrons are move inside the conductor in a random motion. While the electrons are move in random motion, then that time we will consider as relaxation time. Clear? So the collision between the two successive collision, the time between the two successive collision, it is represented with tau. It is called relaxation time. Clear? So final equation, what we will write? Vd equal to capital VE by LM into tau. Capital VE by LM into tau. This is the drift velocity equation in a conductor for free electrons. It's one of the important three more questions for us. Mention the factors on which the resistance of conductor depend. If they will ask this question for two or three more question it is, then you can write directly like this, that is only length of the conductor. Mention the factors on which the resistance of conductor depends. For that, what you can write? First one is length of the conductor, the factors. Second one is area of cross section of the conductor, and third one is temperature of the conductor. Upon these three factors, the resistance will depends. Clear? Suppose the same question, if they will ask instead of this mention, if they ask explain, it is a PO board important passing capsule question. Explain the factors in which the resistance of conductor depends. Explain means how you write. First point I will write. How it is directly proportional to resistance, is directly proportional to length of the given conductor. Resistance is directly proportional to length of given conductor. Then what you can write by using this one? R proportional to L. Directly proportional means what you can write? R directly proportional to L. And inversely proportional to. Second one, what you can write? And inversely proportional to. Area of cross-sectional of given conductor. That means R proportional to 1 by A. By using these two, what you can write? R proportional to L by A. From that, R equal to rho L by A. This is called resistance of given conductor. Are you understand? Explain the factors on which the resistance of conductor depend. Explain if they will ask how it will be, we want to be right. How it is, the resistance is directly proportional to length of the conductor and inversely proportional to area of cross section. So R proportional to L by A, that proportionality if you be removed, then what you can write? R proportional to rho L by A. What are the resistance units? That are ohm. Clear? Define resistivity of conductor, given conductor. Very simple definition it is. How you tell? Previous already we wrote one formula, that is resistance R equal to rho L by A. By using this one, I want to be defined rho. So rho equal to RA by L. So here area of cross section and length will be, take it as a numerically 1. Then rho is nothing but R. That is only the definition for here. What it is? See that the resistivity of material of conductor at a given temperature. What it is? Numerically equals to the resistance of the conductor that material having unit length and unit area of cross section. Unit area of cross section. That means rho equal to R into 1 by 1. Then rho equal to R. Clear? That is known as resistivity of the material. Clear? Resistivity of the material of the conductor is given. Temperature is numerically equals to the resistance of the conductor. From here only we want to be right. The resistance of the conductor of that material having unit length and unit area of cross section. Then rho equal to, then what it is, numerically both are equal, then rho equal to R. Then rho equal to R. What its units are? That units are nothing but ohm meter. What are the factors? It will depends and independent. Okay. Here that only I am writing here. State the factors which the resistance material are depend and independent. Both we want to be right. Independent. Okay. So here for the dependent factors, what are upon that depends? It is, first one is nature of material. Because of resistivity is a specific resistance value for that material. Are you understand? So that it must be depend upon nature of material. It must be depend upon nature of material and temperature of the given conductor. Nature of material and temperature. Upon these two it will depend. What are independent character dimensions? Dimensions means what are that? Length of the given conductor and area of the given conductor. Are you understand? Independent means if length will change, resistivity does not change. If length will change, resistance will change. Are you understand what I am telling? Resistance is entirely different to resistivity. So, if length of the given wire will change, then resistance can change, but resistivity does not change. Why I am mentioning this point? Are you understand? Because of in passing capsule, one question they will give. They gave. What the question they gave? If the wire of length stretched by 3 times, what happened to resistivity of that wire? What the question they asked, are you understand? The length of the wire stretched by 3 times of its original. What about the resistivity of the wire? They are asking that question. What is the answer? Is there any change? Because of independent factors. What are that? Length of the conductor and area. So what happened? It doesn't change. That's why here I put the star mark. Okay. If wire of length will stretch out by 3 times, then resistivity does not change. Most important logical one more question it is. Are you understand? Clear na? The length stretched by 3 times, what happened to its resistivity? They asked that one important passing capsule question. So, what is the answer? Resistivity does not change. Okay, this is a important model paper also. I think so, it is a model paper 1 or 2, one question it is. Length is stretched by 3 times. Then what happened to that resistivity? Doesn't change. Okay. It's important. One mark and two mark questions. These are all. The next question is, draw the graph representing variation of resistivity with temperature.
What it is?
How it will be varied, are you know? The resistivity of conductor vary with the temperature. How it is? With increase in temperature, the resistivity is also be increases. Actually, for a conductor. Okay? But this conductor, if it will be take copper, copper is a good conductor, are you know? So, for that resistivity, how it is? For the temperature rise, the resistivity is very slow, it will increase. Okay? Up to a certain temperature, then after it rise very speed. That graph we can show here in the copper. Up to a certain limit or certain limit of temperature, the copper have good conductor. That already we know that. For the good conductors, that graph will be like this. Okay? For more high temperature, it will be varied. For low temperatures, it could not. So, it will be used as a good conductor. Now, what about the resistivity for nichrome? Nichrome has standard resistance. For high temperatures also be, the resistivity value will very low for it. So, that is like this. Clear na? Third one is a semiconductor. Semiconductors means everyone knows that. If temperature increases up to a certain point, it will decrease like this. Okay. So, its resistivity decreases continuously like this. These are all semiconductors. These are three graphs for three marks. Important. Clear? For copper, it is a good conductor and it is a standard and it is a decreases continuously like that. Clear na ma? Next one is, what is a conductivity? The reciprocal of resistivity is known as conductivity. The reciprocal of resistivity is known as conductivity. That means, rho, sigma equals to 1 by rho. Sigma equals to 1 by rho. Conductivity, it represents with sigma. So, sigma equal to 1 by rho. Ohm inverse. Unit is ohm inverse. SI unit is ohm inverse. Clear? Next one is, here important one more relation, this is the 12th question. Assuming the expression for drift velocity, already we know that what is the drift velocity? The electrons will move opposite to the applied electric field, then electrons get drifted. That drifted velocity is known as drift velocity. Already we learned that. That Vd equal to what you wrote, capital Ee by m into tau, relaxation time. Okay, by using that expression, here what they are asking, derive an expression for conductivity of material. What is the conductivity? It is nothing but a sigma. Previous only I wrote reciprocal of resistance. Okay, so sigma equal to Ne square tau by m. We want to be derived this equation. To derive that one, first we want to be considered one conductor. So, one conductor having a material, its length will be L and area of cross-section will be A and its conductivity sigma, that material conductivity, it is a sigma and carrying current by that conductor is I and current carrying by that conductor is I. And understand, length of the conductor is L, area is A and conductivity is sigma, that conductor carrying a current I. Then what you can write, the current will be passed through the material, that is I equal to what you can write, NaE Vd. This is already in that previous we learned one relation between electric current and drift velocity. That question already we learned. Say yes or no? By using that, what you write here, I equal to NaE Vd, that is equation number one. And drift velocity, this derivation is also be derived for 3 marks, already we derived. So, Vd equal to Ee by Ee, capital E small e by m into tau. Okay, this is equation number 2. Now, already we learned about current density. What is the current density? It is represented with J. J equal to ratio of current to unit area of cross section. That means J equal to I by A. Now, I want to be substitute that I equation here. That means equation 1 will be substitute in equation number 3. Then what do you get? J equal to, instead of this I, what can I write here? NAEVD/A. Clear na? Just here instead of this I wrote this one. That is NAEVD. That only here I wrote by A. Now, this is the fourth equation. In this fourth equation, already BD we knows that. So, in that fourth equation, we will substitute the second one. What it is? Then, J equal to NAE/A into drift velocity, that is capital A small a by m into tau. Now, AA will get cancelled. Then E into E square. So here N it is there. So N. And then after capital E into tau by M. This is the current density J. But ohmic, by using Ohm's law, microscopic formula, what we will write? J equal to sigma E. It is one of the important one more question it is. J equal to sigma E. Now here in equation 5, what we have J? That J what we will write? Sigma E. So from equations of 5 and 6, what we will write? Sigma E equals to N E square E by M into tau. Now E get cancelled. Then sigma E equal to N E square by M into tau. It is the one of the most important question. Clear? Relation between, there is an expression of conductivity of material in terms of N E square tau by M. Sigma equal to N E square tau by M. That we want to be derived. Okay. So first of all, we know current equation I equal to N A V D and drift velocity we know that E by M into tau. Now J equal to current density definition already we know that. So current density that J equal I by A. Now I want to be substituted here N A V D by A. Okay, then after instead of this VD, I will substitute here. Then J equal to what you can write final equation. Then J equal to NE square E by M into tau. This is the equation number 5. But ohmic law, by using microscopic form of Ohm's law, that is J equal to sigma E. Now from both 5 and 6, what you write? Sigma E equal to N E square capital E by M. E both get can cancel. Okay, capital E get cancel each other. Then final formula. What we have that sigma E equal to N E square by M into tau. Okay, up to now what you are learning? That is the most dead important questions. Okay, try to be follow each and every question and learn well. Remaining we will see in next video.